May Allah make us among the lucky ones whom Allah the Almighty will set free on that day from hellfire. May Allah the Almighty forgive us all our sins, accept our deeds. Allahumma ameen. Why are we here today? Besides fulfilling the fifth pillar of the deen, it is a long story. It goes back thousands of years ago. It began with when Allah Almighty stated in Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 124, وَإِذِ بِتَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَأَتَمَّهُنْ قَالَ إِنِّي جَاعِلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا. Remember when Ibrahim's Lord tested him with several serious tests, and when he fulfilled all the tests, when he passed them successfully, Allah the Almighty granted him the imamah, granted him the leadership of the righteous ones. It is not for free. It's a matter of being tested and tried. And it is very interesting that in the seventh hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the most severely tested people are the prophets. Many people, many of us are under the impression that if you are tested, that the most severely tested people are the prophets. The people will be tested in proportion with the level of their iman. People with high iman will be tested more than people with low iman. Why? When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was lying down on his deathbed, and Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, may Allah be pleased with him, touched him, he could not bear the heat, the temperature. He said, Ya Rasulullah, you're very hot. He said, yes indeed, double the fever that any of you would experience. He said, is that because Allah would raise you into a higher rank because of that? He said, yes indeed. So tests and trials are in order either to purify us from our sins, or to raise those who are pure and sinless into the highest ranks, such as the prophets. What are the words, what are the tests which Allah the Almighty tested Ibrahim and his family with? It began with, when he was the only believer on earth, إِنَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ كَانَ أُمَّةً. He was a nation for himself. He was the only believer on earth. And he challenged all the non-believers, all the idolaters, and he destroyed their idols. And as a result, they built up a huge fire for him. It took them like a month to solidify rocks in order to start fire that would really devour Ibrahim alayhi salam. And when they started this fire, they could not come close to push Ibrahim in. So one of them invented a catapult in order to cast Ibrahim from distance into this fire. And he lasted in fire for so many days, tens of days. And when Ibrahim alayhi salam was flying and falling into fire, that's a big test. It is actually the biggest test, but there is even a bigger test. As he was falling in fire, Allah Almighty sent angel Gabriel, peace be upon him, to him, to ask him, Ya Ibrahim, alaka haja? Jibreel alayhi salam, the one who destroyed nations, and the one who saved nations, is asking Ibrahim alayhi salam, do you need any assistance? Can I help you? What was the answer of Ibrahim alayhi salam? Whenever he was in need for help, at this very critical moment, when he was falling in fire, but look at the amount of yaqeen and certainty. Look at the amount of tawakkul, how much he put his trust in Allah. He recognized this angel as Jibreel alayhi salam, the boss, the leader of all the angels. But he says to him, أَمَّا مِنْكَ فَلَا. Help from you? No. أَمَّا مِنَ اللَّهِ فَحَسْبِنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلِ. Allah is sufficient for me indeed, and He is the best disposer of all affairs. How much He trusted Allah. And that Allah the Almighty ordered the fire which He created to burn, which He created to devour. He ordered the fire saying, قُلْنَا يَا نَارُ كُونِي بَرْدًا وَسَلَامًا عَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ. Allah ordered the fire not to be cold, but to be cool and peaceful. And He said, كُونِي بَرْدًا, it would freeze, so that Ibrahim would still die as well. But He said, be cool and peaceful. Ibrahim alayhi salam. 40 days later, when the fire is out, when the fire is down, they checked with Ibrahim alayhi salam, and he was literally untouched. Later on, when he was asked, what is the best time in your life, he said, when I spent the time in fire. It was cool and peaceful. Allah commanded, Allah, كُونِي بَرْدًا وَسَلَامًا عَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمِ. It's a test. But who can bear that test? Ibrahim alayhi salam reached 70 with no children. He was deprived from having a child while he was Khalil Rahman. One of the best companions and friends to Ar-Rahman, to the most beneficent. Why would Allah deprive his loved one from having a son? But after all, when he was so old, Allah Almighty granted him his very first son, Ismail alayhi salam. Ibrahim was too busy occupied playing with his only son. He is celebrating. He is happy. He is delighted. After all, finally, he's got a son. Allah the Almighty delivered the second test, which to many that is even greater than death, when he said to him and ordered him to take his only son, who was still being breastfed, to take him to an abandoned place in the middle of nowhere, to bring him to Mecca, where there was literally no life whatsoever. He did, and he called Hajar, peace be upon her, with her baby Ismail alayhi salam, with a little bit of provision, and he deposited it. He came all the way from Palestine, and he left him in the middle of nowhere. You know, if he stand in Mecca, in one of these tall buildings, and you look at the mountains, it's very scary. Imagine with no buildings whatsoever, with no life, with no water, with no food, no life whatsoever. Then he left them in the middle of nowhere. Hajar alayhi salam, she calls on him, Ya Ibrahim, are you going to leave us here alone? He doesn't answer. He turned around and he left because Allah ordered him to do so. That is his only son. That is his most beloved, but he loves Allah more. He loves Allah more than he loved his only son. He loves Allah more than he loved his own son. Are you leaving us here alone? He doesn't answer. Again, Ya Ibrahim, are you leaving us here alone? He doesn't answer. Then she said, Allah amaraka bihada. Did Allah order you to do that? Only then he turned around to say, yes, he did. Then she said, إِذَا فَلَمْ يُضَيِّعَنَ اللَّهِ. Then we will never get lost. She's in the middle of nowhere. But knowing that this is Allah's wisdom, and this is Allah's command, she trusted Allah Almighty so much so that she said, we will never get lost. Where? In the middle of nowhere. There is not a drop of water. There is not a piece of bread. But she trusted Allah. She had true yaqeen and tawakkul upon Allah. To the point that she's saying, with certainty, we will never get lost. We shall never get lost. Ibrahim alayhi salam lived. Lived him where? Lived him to who? To Allah. Hajar alayhi salam ran out of water and food. She cannot even feed her own baby. She did not stay in waiting for Allah to send down the rain of gold and silver, or the food to come on the table. She made an effort. She started running, jogging between the two hills of As-Safa and Al-Marwa. When she was up, she could see clearly Ismail crying out of hunger and thirst. When she goes down the valley, it was hard to keep an eye on him. And that's why she jogged in this area. This is why every believer, including Ibrahim alayhi salam, Ismail alayhi salam, and all the prophets, including Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and all the believers until the day of judgment, should jog in this segment. Why? Because Hajar, who used to be a slave woman, she was a slave girl. Allah the Almighty made the entire ummah and all the believers take the same footsteps and imitate a woman who used to be a slave woman because she was a believer. Because of how much she trusted Allah. Because of her tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we all follow her footsteps and we rush and we jog in this segment as she did. Peace be upon her. Then after she made seven rounds, jogging back and forth, there is no light. There are no signs to hurt me here. But she trusted Allah and she did whatever she could do. She had utilized the possible means. She made an effort. She tried back and forth. And on the seventh trip, she saw something very weird. Water was gushing forth from beneath the feet of her baby Ismail alayhi salam. She came back running. She couldn't believe herself, but she trusted Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But as a human being, she was afraid that this water may vanish. And that's why she started making a basin around the water. And she kept talking to the water as she's addressing a human being, saying, Zam, Zam. Zam is a command verb which means stay here, don't go anywhere. That's why the name of Zam Zam came from Zam Zam. Stay here, don't go anywhere. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, may Allah have mercy on Hajar. If she did not make that basin, this water would be running like river. And it would be running non-stop. Subhanallah. As a result, the bird started circulating in the air. And people started coming whenever they saw life, whenever they saw water. And he comes back when his son is grown up to visit once. He did not find it. He asked his wife, his daughter-in-law, Ismail's wife, about their life and how do they live. She kept complaining about everything. He said, well, when Ismail returns, tell him that somebody came to visit and he is leaving a message to change your doorstep. Soon he returned, he found the fragrance of his father. He said, did anyone visit? He was in hunting trip. She said, an old man. And he asked about this and that. Did he leave a message? She said, yes. He said, you're divorced. That is the message. Without even seeing his father, he trusted Allah Almighty so much. This is a wise man who trusts the wisdom of his father. So he said, then he comes again to visit his son, and he was gone for the second time. He asked his daughter-in-law, and she does not recognize him, about their life, and if they were suffering of anything. She kept saying, Alhamdulillah, we're living happily, and she praised Allah for everything. So he left the message time to confirm this marriage, because she's a pious woman. Same happened when Ismail returned, and he found the fragrance of his father, and he asked about it, and she said, an old man came, and he left this message. Ismail was happy. But so far he had not met his father, not even once. Then when Ismail alayhi salam grew up to the point that he was able to walk and walk with his father, for the first time Ibrahim alayhi salam saw his father, his son, he saw him with a message. A message that we share it with each other today would say, it's an insane message. It's a crazy message. After long absence, you're coming to tell me that I was ordered to slay you? He saw a light vision that he was ordered to sacrifice his only son, Ismail alayhi salam. قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ إِنِّي أَرَى فِي الْمَنَامِ أَنِّي أَذْبَحُ فَانْظُرْ مَاذَا تَرَى. He consulted his son, said, my dear son, I saw a wahy in my night vision that was commanded to sacrifice you. What do you think? What do you think? Look at the believing son. قَالَ يَا أَبَا تِفْعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرُ سَتَجِدُنِي إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الصَّابِرِينَ Surah Al-Saffan. He said, my beloved father, do as you are commanded. Execute the order of Allah. إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ I will be among the patient ones. فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَا When they both submitted to Allah, the father and the son, وَقَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِيلِ He laid him down. إِرْمِيَا Where our camp is. In order to spare him. And he sharpened his knife. And he turned his face away from him. Ismail said, Father, turn my face away from you. So that we don't have an eye contact. So that we do not think about it for a moment. So that we do not disobey the command of Allah. He sharpens his knife. And he tries to sacrifice his son. But the knife won't go through. He sharpens his knife again, but the knife won't go through. And again and again. وَنَادَيْنَاهُ Then Allah Almighty said, we call upon him, Ya Ibrahim. haqqaqta ru'ya. You have verified the vision. You have fulfilled the command. What are they now? And we ask of him, we ask of Ismail alayhi salam, with a great sacrifice.